Welcome back to AM Northwest. Falls, grayer days can mean darker moods. I know that's true. Here with ways to put the spring back in your step, we're happy to welcome back to AM Northwest psychologist Goalie Sadie. Nice to have you back.
Nice to be back.
I'm glad you're here.
Thank you.
Just in time. You know, we were down at the beach this weekend, and I always love going to the coast, but the day we got there, the rain's coming sideways, the sky is gray. It's just, and it's like, I don't want to be here. Is there really something to the atmosphere, the environment, and your mood?
Absolutely. You know, and I think it's made up of a couple of different components. You know, when you think about the summertime, the days are longer, the weather's great, so you want to be out and about, and people are more active, they're eating better, and that all leads to better mood. And I think when the fall sets in, we start to see this slow decline, and people are not doing as well. And sometimes, unfortunately, it'll get worse and worse, and you're in January and February, and people are highly depressed, and it started much earlier on.
And do you make the point that a lot of times people will use foods to try and compensate for their mood? And they use the wrong foods.
You're absolutely right about that. You know, I think oftentimes, again, in the summer, you'll have fruits and vegetables and salads. You have that lighter fare, right? And then when it's the holidays, it's pies, it's cookies, it's baked goods. And a lot of times, it's a lot of sugars and fats, and that will make us feel really lethargic. We'll be cranky, right? We'll have that sugar crash effect. But oftentimes, you can still eat well, right? You can still, there's still fruits and vegetables around in the fall and winter.
Sure.
You know, I just got this recent vegan cookbook from a good friend that I love, and it has a pumpkin pie smoothie, right? And it has pumpkins, and it has cloves, it has really healthy factors in it. So you can still get your sweet fix, right? But you can do it in a more healthy manner.
All right, do that. Now let's talk about how you use your five senses to combat the gray skies and the mood. That one is sound.
Exactly. I mean, it was interesting. We were just talking about this backstage with our next guest around music and this idea that, you know, oftentimes in the fall, we like more reflective music. I learned this first from my yoga teachers, and they would say, if you go to a yoga class in the fall, you'll hear different music than you will in the spring and summer. So spring and summer is more upbeat, it's drums, it's more lively, and things are a little bit slower and calmer oftentimes in fall and winter. And really, you want to match it with what you need, and so sometimes you might need something more reflective, but if your energy is low, then something upbeat.
Upbeat, sure.
Exactly.
Taste.
Yeah. So taste is, like we were saying, a lot of times the flavors that we have of the summertime are going to be lighter and fresher. So really having things like lemons and citrus, right? We oftentimes forget that those are still available during the season and can really brighten up our mood.
And sight, what we see can make a difference.
Absolutely. You know, we do that spring cleaning, but we don't do it after that, right? And so things get really cluttered. They're really disorganized. You know, when I go to my office, I want it to be clean. I want it to be bright. You know, pops of color, whether it's, you know, bright yellows or even just having things like right here on this table, right? Plants. And being able to have things that are seasonal.
Is that why you say, you know, you can declutter a couple of times a year, not just in the spring, right?
Absolutely.
Touch, you know, the fabrics that are around you and maybe what you wear make
exactly.
a difference.
Exactly. Absolutely. You know, I think oftentimes we think about the colder seasons, meaning wool that's going to be scratchy and uncomfortable. But I think a lot of times you can have fleeces and soft blankets and things like that. And it's really a cozy time of year. So to feel comfortable in that way.
And smell.
Scent.
Sometimes when you're indoors, you know, all winter long, the smell can get pretty rancid.
Absolutely. So you do want to open up those windows and get some fresh air, which I think is really important. But also it's a time when, you know, you can light candles, right, where you usually won't be doing that during the summertime. And you can think about the scents around you. So oftentimes, you know, I like pumpkin scents and vanilla, but also things like orange and cloves can be really warm and invigorating. So thinking about things that will wake you up as well.
Are you... Can you trick yourself by introducing you know, summer colors and smells you know, to trick you in the winter, or is that even not worth the effort?
I think you're absolutely right. That's exactly the point, is to be able to trick yourself, because I think, like I was saying, there's that slow shift away from the many healthy and great things that you were doing during the summertime. So to invite that back in, right? You can still have watermelon and those flavors and scents and textures and all of that around you. You know, I think it's nice to make that progression into the fall, because there's something fun about, you know, Thanksgiving and Halloween and pumpkins and all of that. But, you know, a lot of times people get really into the hustle and bustle and the stress of it.
Yeah.
And they start to associate the holidays with stress, which is not what we want.
Right, exactly. And I think the biggest tip, at least for me, is watch what you eat.
Exactly.
Because you're absolutely right. I just thought an orange glazed donut would be more like a citrus fruit. But no, you're saying that's not true.
No, that's not.
Not good. All right, good to have you here. Thanks for the
tip. Good to be here. Thank you.